Welcome to an example of the second fundamental theorem of calculus that also requires a chain rule. Here we're given f of x equals this integral and asked to find f prime of x and f prime of 1. So one approach would be to find f of x by integrating and then find f prime of x by differentiating. But we can also find f prime of x by using the second fundamental theorem of calculus stated here, where if f is continuous on an open interval containing a constant a, then for every x in the interval, the derivative with respect to x of the integral of f of t from a to x equals f of x. So a couple things to notice here. The lower limit of integration is our constant a. The upper limit of integration is just x, which is the same variable in which we differentiate with respect to. So to find the derivative of this integral, we substitute x for t, giving us f of x. So if f of x is equal to this integral, we can say f prime of x would be equal to the derivative with respect to x of the given integral. But if we compare the form of this integral to the integral in our theorem, we do have a slight problem. Notice in the theorem, the upper limit of integration is just x, and we have x to the fourth. This means we'll have to perform a u substitution before we apply the second fundamental theorem of calculus. Meaning if we let u equal x to the fourth, then we could say that f prime of u, not f prime of x, would be equal to the derivative with respect to u of the integral from negative 1 to u, not x to the fourth, of f of t. So now we can use the theorem to find f prime of u. Remember, our goal is to find f prime of x, which means we'll have to apply the chain rule. F prime of x would be equal to f prime of u times u prime, or df du times du dx. So remember, we let u equal x to the fourth, which means u prime or du dx would be equal to 4x to the third. And now we can find f prime of u by applying the second fundamental theorem of calculus. Remember, to do this, we'll substitute u for t. So f prime of u would be equal to u to the third. So f prime of x is equal to df du, or f prime of u, which would be u to the third, times du dx, which is 4x to the third. But of course, we want f prime of x in terms of x, so now we'll substitute x to the fourth for u. So we'd have x to the fourth raised to the third times 4x to the third. Well, this would be x to the 12th times 4x to the third, which would be 4x to the 15th, which again is f prime of x, which we were looking for. So this is 4x to the 15th power. So to find f prime of 1, we'll substitute 1 for x. Of course, 1 to the 15th is just 1, so we have 4 times 1, or 4. So while we are done, let's go ahead and check this by integrating to find f of x, and then differentiating to check f prime of x. And let's do this on the next slide. So the antiderivative function would be t to the fourth divided by 4. If we'd evaluate at x to the fourth and then negative 1. So when t is equal to x to the fourth, we'll have x to the fourth divided by 4. And then when t is negative 1, we'll have negative 1 to the fourth divided by 4. So we can say f of x is equal to, this would be x to the 16th divided by 4, or 1 fourth x to the 16th. And this would be minus 1 fourth. And now we can find f prime of x be equal to 1 fourth times 16x to the 15th minus 0. Here we have a common factor of 4. There's 1 4 and 4, and 4 4s and 16. So f prime of x is equal to 4x to the 15th, which is the same thing we found using the second fundamental theorem of calculus. as we see here. I hope you found this helpful.